Oh dang, I gotta print some stuff out and also do some math problems. I better go print my CCML video answers. Hope no one's around.
Ooh, CCML video answers? I'll have some of that, please.
See what we have. Oh no, what the heck? Ah!
I won't stand for this, I'll sit.
Problem 1.
Give the remainder when x cubed minus 2x plus 1 is divided by x plus 5. One way to look at this problem is to take a step back and ask, what is division? To do this, let's first look at the example of 10 divided by 4. 10 divided by 4, as we all know, ends up being 2 with a remainder of 2. So we can say that the quotient is 2 and the remainder is 2. In other words, we can form 2 groups of 4 and have 2 left over. Technically speaking, this means that we can express 10 as q times 4 plus r, where q is the quotient and r is the remainder. This will become useful later. Now back to the original problem, we can express f of x as q times x plus 5 plus r. The useful thing about this is that we can plug in x equals negative 5 to get q times 0 plus r, which just leaves us with the remainder, which is what we want. Plugging in negative 5 into our original equation, we get that the remainder equals negative 114.
Got it. See how you like that, huh?
What? Access denied? Self-destruct? What? Wait a minute. No. I'm gonna have to hack even harder.
Problem 2.
For polynomial p of x, p of negative 3 is 10 and p of 2 is 5. Give the remainder when p of x is divided by x squared plus x minus 6. The first thing to notice here is that x squared plus x minus 6 is factorable into x plus 3 times x minus 2. What this means is, just like in problem 1, we can express p of x as q times x plus 3 times x minus 2 plus r. Now, since p of x is divided by a quadratic, r has to be a linear function, which means we can say r is equal to ax plus b. Once again, if we were to plug in x equals 2 and x equals negative 3, we just get the remainder, but in this case we get a system of equations in terms of a and b. Solving the system of equations, we get that a equals negative 1 and b equals 7. Therefore, r has to be negative x plus 7.
Access denied! I better pull out my final move! Problem 3.
Consider the function f of x equals 2x minus 3. If f is composed with itself one time, the result is 4x minus 9. Give an explicit formula for a result when f is composed with itself n times, where n is a natural number. The first thing we can do is we can try to compose f with itself n times, where n is 0, 1, 2, etc., just to see what happens. We'll be doing this for n equals 0 to 4. Also note the notation that when f is composed with itself n times, it expresses f to the n plus 1 of x. Look at these examples, you can start to see a pattern start to show up. Like if you look at the coefficient of x, you see 2, 2 squared, 2 cubed, 2 to the 4th, 2, etc. Right? If you look at the constant, you can see negative 3 times 2 minus 1, 2 squared minus 1, 2 cubed minus 1, 2 to the 4th minus 1, etc. Thus, with our observations, we could write a general form for what our guess is as when f is composed of itself n times, you get 2 to the n plus 1 times x minus 3 times 2 to the n plus 1 minus 1. From here, we can set up what's known as the proof by induction, and we just so happen to set up what's known as a base case, aka proving it works for n equals 0 and n equals 1. So if we assume that we know it for n, and we can prove that it works for n plus 1, then because we know it works with n equals 0, it has to work for all natural numbers. Thus, we compose our f to the n plus 1th function with f once again to get an f to the n plus 2 function. And when we simplify this, we get 2 to the n plus 2 times x minus 3 times 2 to the n plus 2 minus 1. And that follows our pattern, so our proof is solid by induction.
What? Hack back again permanently?
No!
USA, let's go.
Oh no! RIP.
And stolen? But by who? I swear, stop. Who could have done this?
Bad day?
Yeah, man, I just got hacked.
What a coincidence, me too. All my stuff got stolen.
Oh no.
Oh
man.
No, man.
Amateurs.